everyone. I'm Trisha Becker, Developer Relations Lead at Niantic. And in this video series, we're covering everything you need to know to get started with Niantic's Lightship ARDK. In this tutorial, we'll focus on creating a shared AR experience. Sharing is all about creating real-world, multi-user experiences that enable users to connect, play, and interact with virtual objects and each other in real places and in real time. By the end of this tutorial, you'll be able to create your own shared AR experience using the low-level APIs and learn how to use plane tracking to enable users to create objects and share them in their spaces in real time. For the purpose of this tutorial, we've already created our new Unity project, added the Lightship ARDK, and authenticated using Lightship's API key. If this is your first time working with Lightship ARDK, please see our basics video tutorial to learn about the requirements and steps that you need to do to get set up for your first project. Let's get started. The first thing we're going to do to create our shared AR experience is to use managers to control the events and configurations of our project. Managers are a combination of scripts and prefabs that simplify the development with Lightship. We're going to start by using the ARNetworkingSceneManager prefab, which allows us to set up the shared experience and communication between users. The ARNetworkingSceneManager prefab already has a preset camera that's AR ready, so let's start by removing the main camera. To add the ARNetworkingSceneManager, we'll go to ARDK, Extensions, Prefabs, and then drag and drop it into the scene. As you can see, selecting the ARNetworkingSceneManager from the hierarchy panel allows us to see the different properties that we can configure in the inspector panel. We're going to set up the session within the AR session manager. So let's make sure that the use with AR networking session is checked. This comes checked by default, but it's always good to double check. Now we're going to set up the session identifier by going to network session manager. This is the ID that indicates the name of the session that users will share. In order to interact with each other, users have to connect using the same identifier. In this demo, we're going to call our session Shared Experience Test. Keep in mind that we always recommend using a unique prefix to ensure that your sessions won't interact with sessions from other experiences. Awesome. So we've already created the basis of our shared AR experience. Now let's run the scene just to confirm that everything is working correctly. Okay, everything looks good. Let's move forward. Now that we have our shared scene, we're going to concentrate on creating the plane tracker logic to enable users to share their objects. First things first, let's add an empty object into our scene. And for the purpose of this demo, we'll call this AR game. And then we'll add the AR plane manager script from the ARDK package. Now we're going to go to the plane prefab property and add the plane prefab object from the ARDK library. Afterwards, we're going to define which planes that we want to detect on our experience by modifying the detected plane types property. In this case, we'll use horizontal ones. Shared AR experiences do require some C# coding skills, so it's recommended to have some programming and Unity experience before diving in. If you're not very familiar with Unity, check out Unity's learning area, which has tutorials of different levels and focus areas. Now, having said this, we're going to create our own script that will enable us to assign different events to our actions. To do so, we're going to add a new script component, which we're going to call ARGameLogic. Let's open the script and get to it. The first thing we have to do is to access the managers that we're using in our project. In order to do this, we'll create a public property that allows us to interact with the ARNetworkingSceneManager. So let's go ahead and create an ARNetworkingManager public property with the name manager. Remember to import the niantic.ardk.extensions namespace. Okay, let's save the script and go back to Unity so that we can see the property we just created. Now let's assign the ARNetworkingSceneManager of our scene to this property. Now we can access our managers from our script, which contains several interconnected components and scripts. We'll create an event to later subscribe to messages from other users so that we know when a connection starts. Let's create an on-network initialized method and assign it to the connected event inside of our manager.networkSessionManager.networking. I know that was a mouthful, so if you didn't catch it, it's manager.networkSessionManager.networking. Don't forget to import the niantic.ardk.networking.multipeer networking event args namespace in order to access the connected arg struct. And since our managers initialize at runtime, we need to add a simple delay to the connected event so that the manager has time to be created. So simply modify the return value of the start method to IEnumerate and then add a wait for seconds call. In this case, we're using a tenth of a second to delay the initialization a couple of frames. Okay, so far we've created our shared scene, we've implemented our plain tracking logic, and created our script to interact with our managers. Now we're going to add user input to interact with our objects. We'll use the platform agnostic input that's inside of the namespace niantic.ardk.utilities.input.legacy to capture the user's input. So let's import that now. Inside of the update method, we'll process our input and delegate it to an on-tap screen event. Now we already have our tap event, and we also know its coordinates relative to the user's screen. Now it's time to use our tap event to calculate its interaction with the planes that we're detecting. So unlike Unity's traditional raycast, Lightship processes hit test internally with planes. To do this, we first have to access the camera. Now there are several ways to accomplish this task, but for now, we'll create a new public property where we'll store the camera. Now let's associate the camera to this property in Unity. We'll now proceed to work within the onTapScreen method to calculate the point of contact between our tap on the screen and the planes. In order to get this point of contact, we must access the currentFrame data within the AR session. We'll do this by accessing through manager.arsessionManager.arsession.currentFrame. Once we have this input, we can calculate its position in space and then store it in a position variable. Remember, we need to import the namespace niantic.ardk.ar.hittest. At this point, we'll send a message to all users connected to the session with the calculated position. To send the messages, we must use the broadcast data method of the networking, but since the data must be a byte data, we must serialize it before we do so. To serialize the data, we'll start by importing the following system.io and niantic.ardk.utilities.binary-serialization namespaces, and niantic.ardk.networking for some of the broadcast data parameters. Now we can extend our ONTAP screen method to add the serialization and broadcast of the data. After serializing the position, we can send the information using broadcast data. Broadcast data sends the message to all users connected to the current session. AR networking has other methods that allow users to get information. Send data to peer sends the message to a single user defined by its IPeer, whereas send data to peers sends the message to a list of users, which may be a subgroup. In our case, we want everyone to receive the same message, including the host that started the experience. To carry this action, we'll send the following parameters. Tag equals zero is a message identifier. It allows us to evaluate what type of message we're analyzing when we receive it. Data, this is a byte data with the serialized information that we're going to send. Transport type, here we can decide if the messages are crucial or if we could do without them. So in our case, we'll use reliable ordered, which ensures that all messages will arrive at their destination and in the order that they were sent. Remember to import the niantic.ardk.networking namespace. Send to self defines if the message we send should also be sent to ourselves. In our case, to simplify development, we don't discriminate between host and guest, so everyone will receive the messages and react to them. So far, we have our app that connects to the AR networking session, interacts with the planes through taps, and finally, sends a message to all users. Now it's time to receive the information, and for that we must subscribe to the networking so that it notifies us when a message arrives. Inside of the on-network initialized that we created in step 8, we'll add a subscription to the peer data received method. Let's create the onPeer data received method. In onPeer data received, we must deserialize the information received. Now we have our communication methods, which allow us to send and receive messages from all users connected to the session. Finally, we must instantiate the objects and position them in space. To do so, we'll create a game object property where we can set which object we want to instantiate. Then we'll create the createObject method that receives the position in which we want to instantiate our object. And finally, we're almost there. We'll update our onPeer data received so that it calls this method once we receive a position. That's it. You've successfully learned how to create a shared AR experience that enables users to share objects in their real space in real time. Now you can test out what you built on Unity's mockup scene and also on your devices. If you need guidance, check out our virtual studio video or documentation at our website. So what now? Check out our tutorials page for several tutorials over specific Lightship topics. Then join the Lightship community Discord to discuss Lightship projects with other developers. And finally, make sure to follow Lightship on Twitter and Instagram to see projects that are built with Lightship and stay in the know with updates to the platform. Happy building!